According to the directions we've been given, we should meet Jack Foster and his mate from Curley Cattle Transport somewhere out here as they head back to the Curry, as locals affectionately call their town. You've heard the saying, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. Well, the going's been tough in Cloncurry since it was founded in 1866. So tough, the locals came up with a new saying. If you want to keep going, get a Kenworth. Cloncurry is a typical quiet outback township, located 782 kilometres west of Townsville and 189 metres above sea level. While Cloncurry owes its existence to the discovery of copper, its subsequent status as the most important transportation centre in western Queensland can be attributed to its location at the junction of the major roads from Townsville, the Gulf, Longreach and Mount Isa. It's time to catch up with Jack Foster. He's going to tell us a bit more about the T650 Kenworths they specify for their operation. Jack has operated cattle trucks in this area for almost three decades, half of that time for Mick Curley. Mick's livestock carrying business grew from his family's need for cattle transport on their station interests, and he obviously found the right formula. A look around the yard at the number of road train outfits is all the confirmation you'll need to agree. As you'd expect, they're all Kenworths. T650s, in fact.
In the road train business, the T650 involves for about 70% of our road train work. And it evolved from the Kenworth SAR many years ago, the first Australian-built, Australian-designed truck.
In terms of truck models, the T650 is one of the maturest in the current lineup, having survived for more than a decade and a half. Sure, there have been a few refinements along the way, but as one old fella told us, it's pretty hard to improve on perfection. Closer inspection reveals one of the reasons for the Kenworth T650's popularity and its ability to survive in hard, heavy going. It starts right at the front with the sheer strength and rigidity that the crossmember and radiator support provide.
It's crossmember, which holds the radiator, it's all knitted together, so that makes it so much stronger in the front end, including the steering box set forward, which makes a T650 unique.
Another reason for the T650's overall appeal is its ability to perform equally as well in a wide variety of applications. Like the trucks that haul them, these Haulmark stock crates are arguably the best around. Haulmark has specialised in building trailers for over 40 years, and these ones were made in Brisbane specifically to suit the conditions here in northwest Queensland. According to Jack, the design features of these modern stock crates have come a long way since he first got into the game. The most significant evolution in stock crate design is probably the reduction in tear weight without loss of the strength and durability needed to withstand the punishment of the outback. The cattle's welfare is one of the most significant issues facing cattle haulers. Up here, where cattle cartage is big business, caring for the beasts on your trailers can mean the difference between being asked to cart again or being told, don't call us, we'll call you. As you can imagine, the temperature in the outback can get a trifle hot. These crates, unlike those found down south in highly populated areas, are designed to provide greater airflow for the cattle. They're also what are known as self-cleaning, as manure can escape out of the slots in the bottom of each deck. If you've ever stood in a yard near these northern cattle, you'll also appreciate the safety features for the driver on these Haulmark trailers, especially on the bottom deck. See the large rectangular openings along the side? They're designed so that if a beast turns in the crate and decides to have a go at the driver can easily slide out. The large square tube means that he won't tear himself to pieces in the process either. Murray Egan agreed to demonstrate how important that side opening on a Haulmark trailer is.
Spent nearly the last 20 years cutting stock in the north. Yeah, I spent most of the time working out of Cloncurry with the likes of Hudson's Transport and Curley Cattle Transport and a bit of RDA. And so I'm here trying to pen these cattle off and they push back and there's some mad ones in there and I've got to get out in a hurry. Well, I can just let go of that and I can fly straight through here very quickly. As you can see, I'm out very quickly. And I can get in and out whenever I want without any problem. It should be bigger, because there's a lot bigger fellas around than me driving trucks. And at this edge here, pretty hard on the gut to slide over in a hurry. And these bars that they have coming down here, like this is a good one, hasn't got the one here. And at least this one here, you got half a chance, but yeah, like I can only just get out of this one. And this one here, like with that extra thing there, I wouldn't have a chance at all, even at my size. And to come out of here in any hurry, it's gonna hurt. And to get in, like there's nowhere to, you know, grab hold of anywhere to get back in a hurry. Like there's nowhere to grab. Like it's really safe, like the mole trailers, and you got to go in there like this. And this sharp edge on your back's not good, and that's the easiest way in, the quickest way in, and the easiest. So, but a simple rectangle hole, and it's so much easier, and very important as far as I'm concerned. Because a lot of blokes wouldn't be here today if they hadn't been able to get out of crates in a hurry.
My name's Jack Foster. I've been here in Cloncurry since 1974, driving road trains. And I've been with Curley's for the last 13 years. And up until the last 2 years, I was driving road trains full time. Now I work in the shed and I do most of the maintenance. So these road trains got a double rail chassis with all the weight that we carry, with the three fuel tanks with 2,000 litres of fuel that we carry. And you've got to have a double rail chassis. Carry the weight. The dolly pull here, it's part of the rear cross member. It's pulling the dollies round, pulling the dollies out from under the trailers. We've got a Kenworth 6-rod suspension here. It's a widespread in here. It's also low profile. It's to keep the double deck crates under 4.6 metres. Height. We specify steel fuel tanks because if you ever break one or crack one open, you can always weld it up anywhere in a cattle station somewhere. You can just get an ordinary weld and weld them up, which you couldn't with aluminium. If you have a look over here, we've got a dust-free breather, which it's a Kenworth breather. And for all the places that we go to, in a lot of bull dust and that, you need a special breather like these to stop the breather from blocking up. If the breather blocks up, well, you stop your fuel from running from one tank to the other, and eventually it'll run out of fuel. So you need these type of breathers on them.
It hasn't rained in the Curry for over 2 years, but the dark clouds that had been threatening rain all week finally opened up as we arrived at Ross, Kian and Jar to organise a run to the Selwyn mine.